Hello and welcome to Division with Decimals by Professor G. I'm going to just teach you how to do long division with decimals today. And so we're just going to start with some vocabulary. All right. And so the first thing is outside of the division bracket is the divisor. Okay. So the divisor is on the outside. On the inside is the dividend, and the answer that we get is the quotient. Okay, so those are the three pieces. Division is the multiplicative inverse. It's the opposite of multiplication. It undoes it, and so the rules are the same, with basically a minor tweak, okay? When you multiply some numbers together, let's say you have a number like this multiplied by a number like this, right? Something with two places after the decimal and something with one place after the decimal. Remember, you count. All right, and your product is going to have three places after the decimal. You want to make sure that you have three places after the decimal for the product. Okay, so this is what your answer would look like. Now, typically what we would like to do is we would like to be able to count for division. But what happens is when I have a divisor that has some decimal places in it, the dividend is really the product of a multiplication, okay? And so the quotient is really one of those things that we would like to count. And so it makes it a whole lot harder to figure out where the decimal place should go, because the two things that I'm counting should add up to be the third thing. And, you know, are there some zeros over here that I'm not counting that I would move the decimal place over? Where does it go? I don't know. So we have this rule in division, all right, that helps us avoid any confusion in counting. And the rule in division is no divisor with a decimal less than one. Alright? So basically what this means is we just want whole numbers. If you want to get real technical, it would be integers, but we're just going to talk about whole numbers. Okay? So let's look at an example. Alright? So here's our example that we're going to work with. Let's say you had 0.4 and you want to divide that into 12.5. Let's say this arose in an algebra equation that you were trying to solve. You're like, oh man, what do I do with this, right? Well, what I do first is move the divisors a decimal point till I have a whole number. So here I just need to move it over one to make four. And so then what would happen second is move the dividends, the same number. The dividends decimal point, the same number, right? So I move this over one, so I'm going to move this over one. I'm going to have that divided into 125. Okay? So basically what I'm saying is that 0.4, 4 tenths, will go into 12 and 5 tenths the same number of times that 4 will go into 125. And you're thinking, is this really true? Are these really equivalent divisions? And say, well, this is like 40 cents being divided into a $12.50. This is like saying 4 dimes divided into 125 dimes. And I hope it's pretty easy to see that 40 cents is 4 dimes and $12.50 would be 125 dimes. So these are exactly equivalent. And the nice thing about this is there's no conversion back in the quotient, right? There's no conversion. Okay. And what this allows us to do then is to just divide 4 into 125. Now, the second part of this, and I need some more room, so we're going to go over to the other part. The second part of this is just, now I just need to do division with decimals. So here's our 4, here's our 125, okay? And so now I'm just going to start by a guess. And by a guess, I mean a Price is Right guess. What is going to get me close to 1 without going over? And the answer is nothing, 0, right? So I'm going to move over again, and I'm going to look at 12. And my guess is, what can I get to 12 without going over? And the answer is 3. And so now I actually do my multiplication. 3 times 5 is 12. Then I subtract, which is to change the sign. And I get 0. And then I bring down. And it's the next decimal place value is the 5. And now I repeat this process. Okay? So what times 4 is going to get me Price is Right close to 5? 1 will. 1 times 4 is 5. Change the sign. Oh, I'm sorry. It's 4. And 4 from 5 is 1. Okay? Now you have this remainder here. So you're like, oh, what am I going to do with this remainder, right? Because now I don't have anything to bring down. Well, this is division, right? You should have a decimal answer for your quotient, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a decimal place after the end of the divisor, dividend, because that's where it goes. I'm going to add a 0. And now I have something to bring down, and there's the 0. And so now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to bring the decimal point straight up. Okay. And so I go, now what times 4 is going to get me Price is Right close to 10? 2. Because 2 times 4 is 8. Change the sign. 2 left over. Now I still have a remainder. Well, I already put the decimal point in. I already have my tens place covered. So now I just need to add another 0 for the hundreds place. Now I have something to bring down. Price is Right is 5. 5 times 4 is 20. Change the sign. Nothing left over. So I need to repeat until I have 0 as a remainder. And the nice thing here is, if I was going to multiply this, 4, right, has no zero, nothing after the decimal place. The dividend has 2 zeros after the decimal place, and so we would expect 2 decimal places in our answer, and we do have 2 decimal places in our answer. All right, and so it takes the whole counting thing out. You just bring it straight up. All right, there's our little review of division with decimals, taking care of a decimal in the divisor, and the needing of decimal places to get rid of our remainder. I hope you found this instructive, and check out the rest of the Math 24 lectures.